Okay, we're back, and what we're going to do in this segment is we're going to put all three of these chords together. Now, I want to show you a little example. The three chords I'm starting you on, these three chords go together. For example, if you come across a song that's played in E major, well then, B7th and A, or A7th, you can use A7th, they go with E, okay? Like, for example, and I don't know what kind of music you like, but I'm just going to give you an example. Like the old song, Blue Eyes Crying in the Rain, it starts in E. In the twilight, there I see her. Go to B7th, Blue Eyes Crying in the Rain, back to E. Then when they go to the chorus, they go, when we kissed goodbye and parted. I know, I'm no Willie Nelson. But those three chords go together in that song. And okay, if you're going to sing any song in E major as your primary chord, as your bass chord, then B7th and A7th are going to go with it. Like, hear that? I just used three chords. E as my primary chord, B7th and A7th as my accompanying chords. Okay? But what we're going to do right now is we're going to practice. Now you remember, like when you're in E, you pick your sixth string, strum, fifth string, and strum, back and forth, just like that. Now I want you to go to A7th. Pick your fifth string, strum, sixth string, or top string, and strum. Fifth string again, top string, and then I want you to go to B7th. Or no, wait a minute, just go to back to E, because you know E better. And now go to B7th. You know, you switch these two fingers, they change positions, and then you put that one, the number four finger on the bottom string, and you pick your fifth string, then bring that finger up on the top string, pick your top string. Then back down on the fifth string. See how I'm doing that? Then go back to E. Now here's a good thing to practice right now. Okay, you know three chords. Now trust me on this, okay? I have done this for years. I have taught children and I've taught adults for over 30 years. I want you, once you get used to E, and B7th and A7th, what I want you to do, and I'm very serious about this, I want you to practice changing chords without moving. Now, I'm going to look away. Now, I'm going to go from E major to A7th. Here we go. I'm going to count you off. And I'm just going to strum down, okay? A 1, 2, 3, 4. Stay there. Now we're going to go to A7th. See, I changed. I didn't even look. Stay there. Go back to E major. And you hear how clear those chords are? It's because I'm using the middle of my fingertips. Now let's go to B7th. Fifth string down. Now this time I'm going to count you off, okay? And I'm going to do it slow. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Again. 1, 2, 3, 4. Go to A7th. 1. to E. 1, 2, 3, 4. Go to B seventh. 1, 2, 3, 4. Go back to E. 1, 2, 3, and stop. Alrighty. Now, did you see that? And trust me, guys and gals, you're gonna mess up. Okay, you are gonna mess up. And the thing is, don't be afraid to play, and certainly don't be afraid to practice. And also, I want to tell you this: you already know three chords now, and you've been working hard. Your fingertips are going to be sore. They are going to get sore. I've been playing since I was 3 years old, and I'm 50 now. My fingertips at times when I play too much, like I just got out of the studio playing with the group. Then I had to go to a concert and play that night. So today, at taping, my fingertips are pretty sore. So what I do is I get me a little bowl of ice water, and I just simply dip my fingers down in there. Okay? Take a break, get you some ice water, and then dip your fingers down in there, and it will feel great, I'm telling you. But now, your fingertips being sore is a natural thing. Now, if they start bleeding and giving you problems, I suggest you see a doctor. But when your fingers start hurting real bad, just take you a break. You can always run this tape or this DVD, whichever one you bought. You can always run it back to the point where you left off, okay? Alrighty. So, take a break, and when we come back, we're going to do some more picking. I'm going to show you some more chords. Okay, I'm going to show you D, G, C,